So the first tutorial in electric circuit analysis or electrical sciences will discuss some fundamental problems. Problem number one, given a figure which shows the current that is flowing through a capacitor. So the current is on the y-axis, the unit is in ampere, the time is given in microsecond. You have to determine the charge that is acquired by the capacitor up to the first 5 microseconds. So here some 5 microseconds would be there somewhere. You have to determine what is the charge acquired by the capacitor. So let us see the solution. So we know the relationship of current, charge and time from the 12th standard concept is the current is basically charge per unit of time. So the charge can be obtained from here is I into T. It means that the charge acquired by the capacitor would be the area under the curve of the current for the first 5 microseconds, that is the problem that has been asked. Now in this problem, if you see the curve that has been given is not very uniform. We have to split the curve in such a way that up to 5 microseconds, we need to determine the charge. So if we divide the area based on up to 0 to 5 microseconds among the different areas, like OAC, ABD, BDEC, DGH and DHIEI. So here the nomenclature is given. You have your A, B, C, D, E, F, G and I. So basically the purpose is that we divide the non-uniform region into some uniform region of a triangle and a rectangle so that the calculation of area become easy. Then we need to calculate the area of each zone separately with the concept of area of triangle and rectangle. And when we do the summation of this, we will find what is the charge that is enclosed over an area, which is 15 microcoulomb. So the answer for the particular question is up to 5 microsecond, what is the charge? So the charge is 15 microcoulomb. So this is problem number one. Let us go to problem number 2. In problem 2, we have two coils which are connected in parallel. Now remember, when there is something which is connected in parallel, the coils, the voltage will remain always constant. So you know that in parallel circuit, the voltage is constant and in series circuit, the current is constant. So here we have two coils which are connected in parallel. Now the source is given, which is 100 volt DC supply. So this is our source, which is 100 volt DC supply. Now taking a current of 10 ampere from the source, so this is our total current that is being taken by the coils. So the power dissipated in one coil, so this is the energy power which is dissipated in only one coil. What is the resistance of each coil? So we have two resistances R1 and R2 corresponding to two coils which are connected in parallel. So we have to find what is the resistance of each coil. So let us see the solution. Now we have been given the effective value of the voltage and effective value of the current. That is the total voltage by total current will give you the total resistance of the two coils. So the total resistance of the two coils which are connected in parallel would be 10 ohms because 100 volt is the voltage and 10 ampere is the current source. It means that the relationship between power P equal to V square by R, right? And the power is given to be 600 watt in one coil and the voltage which is constant is given to be 100 volt. Now what is the corresponding resistance R1 of the one coil? So we can get the value of resistance by solving this equation, which gives us to be 16.67 ohms. So we have got the resistance of one coil. Now the remaining resistance is there for another coil. Now we know that two coils which are connected in parallel, their equivalent resistance R equivalent is equal to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Now the equivalent resistance is given, which is 10 ohms. Resistance 1 you have already calculated 16.67 ohms. So it is easy to calculate the second resistance R2 by putting in the equation, which will give you the value of R2 is equal to 25 ohms. This is the solution for problem number 2. We'll move to problem number 3. Now in problem number 3, the question is related to incandescent lamps which are connected in series. The power rating is 200 watt and the voltage rating is 220 volt. So the question is, how many of these lamps are connected in series such that they consume the same total power when a single lamp of rating given as 100 watt and 220 volt is used? So how many lamps will be there? So let us see the solution. So again, we'll start our solution from the resistance, because the resistance information is not given. The voltage is given, the power is given. So we can easily calculate what is the resistance of the bulb. So it is 242 ohms. So the resistance of one bulb is 242 ohms. Now it has been told that we have to connect 100 watt bulb. So what is the resistance of the one bulb of entire combination? So it is resistance 2 will be 220 square, that is the voltage square, by the power. Now that new power is 100 watt. So it gives to be 484 ohms. So it means that 484 ohms is the resistance of one bulb. So the question was asked, how many bulbs you need to connect? So we know that for a series combination, R equivalent is given to be R1 plus R2. Now R equivalent is given to be 484 ohms and one bulb resistance is given to be 242 ohms. It means that for a 220 volt supply connection, we require two bulbs of resistance 242 ohms to be connected in series. Then only we will get a power which is equal to 100 watt, because the power is, again, the formula is V square by the R equivalent. So it gives to be 100 watt. So the answer to this question is, we will be connecting two lamps in series. So this is the solution for third block. We'll go to the fourth problem. When a resistor R, we don't know what is the value of the resistor, is connected to a current source, it consumes a power of 18 watt. So this is the 18 watt is the power consumed when you are connecting across a current source. Now the same resistor, when connected to a voltage source having the same magnitude as the current source. So the voltage source magnitude is equal to same as the current source magnitude. So the power absorbed by the resistor is 4.5 watts. So somewhere the power is consumed and here it is absorbed. So both are same. The magnitude of the current source I, what is the magnitude of the current source I? And what is the value of the resistor R? So that you need to determine from the question. So let us see the solution. Now, case 1, when a current source is connected across R, we know the formula for the current source power is equal to I square R. And the inert power consumed is 18 watt. On the other hand, the case 2 was given that voltage source of magnitude I volt is connected across the same resistor, and we know the formula for power is equal to V square by R, whereas V is equal to I. So we write power 2 is equal to I square by R, which is 4.5 watt. So this is our first equation, this is our second equation. So once we get the both the equation, if we multiply both the equation 1 into 2, what we get, P1 into P2 will be equal to I4, because the resistance will cancel out each other. And if you multiply 18 watt with 4.5 watt, we get 81 watt. Now the fourth root of the current will give you 3 ampere. So the first answer is the current is equal to 3 ampere. Question was asked, what is the resistance? So resistance is basically again equal to power, which is equal to 18 watt divided by the square of the current. So you have already find out the current, which is equal to 3 amps. So the current square will be 9, and you can put in the power formula 18, that will give you 2 ohms as the resistor. So we have found out the current and the resistor. This is the solution fourth. Let us move to the problem fifth. The charge delivered by a constant voltage source determines the current supplied by the source. So here we have the charge. Unit is in millicoulomb and the time is on the x-axis, where the unit is in second. So you have to find the current. So earlier we have found out the charge. Now we are going to find out the current. So from this graph, we can find out the current for time t equal to 1 second and time t equal to 3 seconds. So here somewhere here it will be 1 second, and here somewhere it will be 3 seconds. So what is the corresponding current? So the magnitude of the current you need to find how much. So let us see the solution. So this is the charge graph that has been given to us. We have two lines or two slopes in the graph, the slope of AB and slope of BC. So we have to use the concept of the coordinate system to find the slope, because we have to find the current. So current is equal to Q by T. So here, if we find the slope, we find the current. So for the positive slope, the current is 5 milliampere for a time t equal to 0 to 2 second. And for a negative slope, we have the current is minus 3.33 milliampere for time 2 to 5 second. So can we draw a graph for the current from the charge graph? So on the y-axis, we have the current. On the x-axis, we have time. And we have splitted these into different time instant. So the question was asked 1 second and 3 second, what was the magnitude of the current? So 1 second, the magnitude is 5 milliampere, and at 3 second, the magnitude is minus 3.3 milliampere. So this is the solution for problem number fifth. Move to problem number sixth. Now in problem number sixth, you have a toaster whose rating is given as 1000 watt and 240 volt, which is connected to a 220 volt supply. Will the toaster be damaged? So we have to do an analysis to find whether the toaster will be damaged and what is its rating be affected. Will its rating be affected? So toaster power rating is given, toaster voltage rating is given, which is 240 volt. But the supply, that is 220 volt. So we have to determine whether the toaster will be damaged or not, and what is the rating will be affected or not. So let us see the solution. So from the voltage rating and power rating, the first thing that we need to determine is what is the resistance of the toaster. So the resistance of the toaster from 240 volt and 1000 watt power, we get 57.6 ohms as the resistance. So it means that the maximum current rating of the toaster is equal to power by voltage. So 1000 watt divided by 240 volt will give you 4.167. It means that this is the maximum current that can flow through the toaster. Any current above it will burn the toaster. Now, the toaster is connected to 220 volt supply. So what is the current that is flowing in the toaster when the supply is 220 volt? We know from the Ohm's law that the current is equal to voltage by resistance. Resistance we have calculated as 57.6 ohms. So voltage is 220 volt and resistance is 57.6. So that gives you the current 3.82 amps. So if we compare the maximum current, which is 4.167, and the current which is flowing 3.82, we can decide that the current is less than the maximum current. So the toaster will not be damaged. Now the second part of the question was, what is the power rating of the toaster or consume rating? So power is equal to voltage multiplied with current. We have been 220 volt as the supply. 3.82 was the current which is flowing through the toaster. So the power is 840.4 watt. However, this power rating is less than the original power rating, which is 1000 watt of the toaster. So the toaster will not burn or not be damaged because its power rating, which is power consumed, is less, as well as the current is less. Problem 7. What is the maximum voltage that can be applied across the series combination of 150 ohm 2 watt resistor and 100 ohm 1 watt resistor? So you have been given two resistors of different rating. One rating you have been given as 150 ohm 2 watt. Another one is 100 ohm 1 watt. They are connected in series, so without exceeding the power rating of either resistor. So can you determine what is the maximum voltage that can be applied at the source? That is the problem. Let us see the solution. We know that power relationship P equal to I square R. So the maximum safe current for the 150 ohm resistor, that is the first resistor, is current will be equal to root of P by R from this relationship. And the power is given to be 2 watt, whereas resistance is given to be 150 ohms. So the current that we obtain is 0.115 ampere. Now for the case 2, this is for 150 ohms. Now we'll determine for 100 ohms. Same thing, we'll determine the current, power by resistance of the root. The power is given to be 1 watt. Resistance is 100 ohms. So we get the current to be 0.1 ampere. Question is asked, what is the maximum current cannot exceed, the maximum current cannot exceed the leisure of the two currents. So here you have 0.1 ampere and here you have 0.115 ampere. So the leisure of that is 0.11 ampere, is the maximum current that would be passed with the two things or the two resistors. So the maximum voltage would be the current, which is equal to 0.1 ampere, and the sum of the resistance, because it is connected in series. So resistor will be 150 plus 100. So that would give you 25 volt as the maximum voltage that can be applied to the two resistors which are connected in series of different rating. Problem 8. You have a wire which is 50 meter in length. So you have been given the length and 2 millimeter square in cross-sectional area. The resistance of the wire is 0.56. A 100 meter length of the same wire has a resistance of 2 ohms at the same temperature. Find the diameter of this wire. So you need to find what is the diameter of the wire. So the question has been given under the cases that 50 meter length, 2 millimeter square area has a resistance 0.56. Now the length is 100 meter and the resistance is 2 ohm. You have to find the diameter of the wire. Solution, let us see. Since both wires are of same material, so the resistivity of the first case and second case will be equal. And the case 1 and case 2 are given. Case 1 has length 50 meter. Case 2 has length 100 meter. Case 1 has area 2 millimeter square and resistance 0.56. Case 2 resistance is 2 ohms, but area is not given. So how do we determine the diameter? We know that the resistance is equal to rho L by A. So rho 1 is equal to rho 2 because the material is same. So can we put it the two cases R1 multiplied with A1 by L1, and the second case we put it on this side to find the resistivity of R1 and R2. Substitute the value of the given quantities, and the unknown variable is the area of the second case that we will determine as 1.12 millimeter square. But the question was asked, what is the diameter? So we know the formula of area is pi d square by 4. usually we write pi r square. So if you convert the radius to diameter, it will be pi d by 2 square. So that will give you pi d square by 4. Area is given to be 1.12 millimeter square. So only one variable is diameter, which we need to find, and it will be 1.19 millimeter. So this is the solution number A. Problem number 9, we have a voltage source across a 10 ohm resistor given by the figure. Find the average power dissipated by the resistor. So on the y-axis we have voltage, and on the x-axis we have the radian angle omega t. So can we find the power that is absorbed by the resistor of the average power? Okay, so let us see. So the formula for average power is P average equal to V RMS square by R, where the value of the R is given to be 10 ohms. We need to find the average power. So average power relationship is given as 1 by time period integral of P dt, where P is divided into different zones of the time. So if we take the resistor out 1 by 10 and we integrate from 0 to 2 pi by 3, that is 10 square was given in the question, and from 2 pi by 3 to pi minus 10 square was given as the power. So on integrating, we get the power to be 10 watt. So 10 watt is the power which is dissipated in a resistor. So here we can see that from 0 to 2 pi by 3 we have 10 volt, which is we are putting it here, and from 2 pi by 3 to pi we have minus 10 volt, which we are putting here. So we can determine the average power from the relationship 1 by t integral of power dt, which gives to be 10 watt. Problem 10, a wire wound resistor is to be made from a 0.2 mm diameter constant end wire wound around a cylinder. So we have a cylinder of 1 centimeter diameter. So this is the diameter of the cylinder. How many turns are needed for a resistance of 50 ohms? So here the wire will be wound and the resistance will be 50 ohms. The resistivity of the material is given to be 49 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. So the wire is having a diameter of 0.2, okay, and 1 centimeter is the diameter of the cylinder. Total resistance is 50 ohm. So we have to determine the number of turns required. Let us see the solution. We know that the resistance is rho L by A from the formula. Resistivity value is given to us 49 into 10 to the power minus 8. The resistance required is 50 ohms and the diameter of the wire is 0.2 millimeter. So the area can be calculated as pi d square by 4 of the wire, which comes to be 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 8, because the diameter will put it here in the equation of the area. Now, the resistance which we required as 50 ohms in the formula for rho L by A, where the resistivity is 49 into 10 to the power 8, and you have a cylinder where the length is not given of the cylinder, right? So we need to find what is the length of the cylinder, because the area we have already calculated. So from this relationship, the length comes to be 3.204 meter. However, our question is, how many turns are required? We know that the length is equal to 2 pi r into n, where 2 pi r is basically the circumference of the cylinder. This is 2 pi r, and this is our cylinder which is having n turns of the wire, and that will be the total length. So the radius, number of turns we need to find, because the radius is 0.5 centimeter, which is given to us. Length we have already calculated, 3.204. So n value we are getting 101.98, which on approximation to whole figure, it is 102 turns. So basically we required 102 turns of wire to complete the total resistance. Problem 11, the average value of the current waveform is given to us. So we have the current here, and on the x-axis we have omega t. So we need to find what is the average current. So can we write an equation for this current for an instant 0 to pi, because pi is basically our time period, because time period is pi. So the current equation from 0 to pi by 2, which is having an increasing slope, and from pi by 2 to pi, which is having a decreasing slope, we can write the equation of the line, that is the straight line equation. From 0 to pi, we split up from 0 to pi by 2 and pi by 2 to pi. Then we know that the average current we need to find. So the time period is pi, and we have to integrate from 0 to pi by 2 for the current equation that is given, and from pi by 2 to pi, the current equation that we have to given for the time dt. So if we integrate and then we put the definite integral from t to 0 to pi by 2 and pi by 2 to pi, we find 7.5 ampere as the average current that is flowing in the circuit. So this is for solution 11. Problem 12, we have a domestic power load in a house that comprises of 8 lamps of 100 watt each, 3 fans of 80 watt each, 1 refrigerator of half horsepower. Now here the unit is given horsepower. So horsepower, 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. 1 heater of 1000 watt. So these are basically the load on the house. Calculate the total current I taken from the supply of 230 volt. So this is the supply voltage, 230 volt. What is the current? Case 2, calculate the energy consumed in a day. So what is the energy consumed per day? Now condition is given that the average only a quarter of the above load. So 1 by 4 is the quarter multiplied with 24, that is the hour per day, is the load being operated at a time. So let us find the current and the energy. So first we'll divide the item and the load. So 8 lamps of 100 watt each will give you 800 watt. 3 fans of 80 watt each will give you 240 watt. 1 refrigerator of half horsepower will give you 373 watt. And 1 heater of 1000 watt will give you 1000 watt. Now the summation will get 2413 watt as the total load on the house. So once we get the total load, that is in terms of the power, so on dividing it with voltage of 230, we'll get the current which is taken from the supply, that is 10.5 ampere. So 10.5 ampere is the current drawn from the supply for a load of 2413 watt. Question was asked, what is the energy consumed per day? So here the power 2413 and 1/4 of the day was under load condition. So 1 by 4 into 24 will give you watt hour. Now remember, watt is the unit of power, and when you multiply it with time, that will give you energy, and the unit will be watt hour, and the bigger unit will be kilowatt hour. So kilowatt hour is the unit of energy that is consumed per day, that is 14.478. Problem 13. Now the waveform of the current passing through an inductor of resistance 1 ohm and inductance 2 Henry is given. Now question is that we have an inductor which is not ideal. So we have a resistor and we have an inductor that is a non-ideal inductor of resistance 1 ohm and inductance 2 Henry. What is the energy absorbed by the inductor in the first 4 seconds? So time is 4 seconds and current is given to be 6 ampere from 2 seconds to 4 seconds. You need to find the energy absorbed by the inductor. Let us see the solution. You know that the energy of the inductor is given by the formula half Li square. So the current is a function of time. So can we integrate that from 0 to 4 seconds? Inductance value is 2 Henry. So the energy that we want to get from 0 to 4 second is 36 joule because the inductance is 2 Henry. So this is because we have a resistor and an inductor. Here we are getting 36 joule. What about the resistor? Because it is a non-uniform element. So energy absorbed by the resistance will be integration of I square R into T, because we need to integrate the power over the time dt, and from 0 to 4 second, the resistance value is already given to us. So can we integrate and find that comes to be 96 joule. So if we add 96 with 36 of the resistor and the inductive component of the energy consumed, we'll get 132 joule as the net energy absorbed by the physical inductor, which comprise of a resistor and an inductor. So this is solution 13. We'll move to solution 14. You have a current which is entering the positive terminal of a device. Now the current equation is given, which is a time dependent quantity, 3e to the power minus 2t ampere, and the voltage across the device is also given, which is 5di by dt. Now few items you need to calculate. First, the charge delivered to the device between 0 to 2 second, power absorbed, and the energy absorbed in 3 second. These are the quantities that you need to determine. So let us see the solution first. The charge is integral of current with respect to time, that is dt. You put the current equation 3 to the power minus 2t, integrate it from 0 to 2, you'll get 1.4725 coulomb as the net charge over the time. Whatever to the voltage, because the voltage is given 5di by dt, the current is 3e to the power minus 2t, you differentiate it, you'll get minus 30e to the power minus 2t. So the power is basically the product of voltage into current. This is the voltage, this is the current, you multiply, you'll get minus 90e to the power minus 4t watt. So the energy is the integral of power over the time 0 to 3 second we need to integrate. So get minus 22.5 joule as the net energy of the system. So we have determined the charge, we have determined the power, we have determined the energy of the system. Problem 15 is the last problem for today's tutorial. So the charge entering the positive terminal of an element is given as this equation, 10 sine 4 pi t, and the unit is in millicoulomb, while the voltage across the element is given is 2 cos 4 pi t volt. So the question is, find the power delivered to the element at time t equal to 0.3 second and the energy delivered to the element between 0 to 0.6 second. So we need to determine the power, we need to determine the energy, 0.3 second and 0 to 0.6 second. So the current is dq by dt. So you differentiate the charge with respect to time, you get 40 pi cos 4 pi t milliampere. And the power formula is the product of voltage into current. Voltage is given, so the current you multiply, you will get the power formula. And you need to determine at time 0.3 second what is the corresponding power. So you get the power as 164.5 milliwatt as the power formula. Now the energy, this is the last part of the determination. So integral of power dt, power equation you have, that is cos square of 4 pi t, you take the common out 80 pi, integrate it from 0 to 0.6 second, that is being asked in the question. So on putting the definite integral, we find 78.34 millijoule as the net energy. So current we have determined, power we have determined, and energy we have determined. So this is all about the first tutorial.